Song Texas Flood, and this is taken out of the live performance at Live at El Mocambo. On the chorus after the two verses, the first two verses, when he gets to the five chord of that song, he plays the turnaround like I've never heard him play it before on any other occasion, actually. And he starts it off by sliding up into the five position. Really, really fast, so I'm going to play the notes of that first part of the riff as slowly as I can, and you're going to have to watch my fingers because there's too many notes for me to call out where each and individual one is on each fret. But if you watch real closely and then, you know, pause the video, you should be able to catch them all. All right, so here's how he slides into it. Let me try that one more time. One note about this section is when Stevie gets to this bend right here, he switches from his bridge pickup to his neck pickup to give it a little bit of extra scream. So when played at full volume, it sounds like this. Alright, when Stevie gets done playing that riff on the five, he slides down to the four because that's how every ending of every blues progression goes. And he plays the same opening on the four that he did on the five. He goes down to the four. That's where the similarities end, because as soon as he's done with that, he goes into this funky little pattern, and I'm going to play this as slowly as I can. All right, let me try that one more time. Let me try it one more time. And then he finishes it up by sliding down to the root box. All right, so I'm going to play it out of the four here. That's tough, but the only thing I can say is that this riff is going to take a lot of practice to play it smoothly, and it's totally worth it though, because it forces you to work on your timing, and you get to play some stuff that Stevie Ray Vaughan only did once, and that seemed to be it. So once again, when you put it all together and play it at speed, it goes like this. Have some fun, and hopefully you won't get as frustrated over that as I did.